guys, welcome back to my channel. I'm so excited to be filming again for you guys. I feel like it's been a while, but I'm back with another makeup tutorial, and for today's makeup look, I'm gonna be using only drugstore products. The reason why I decided to do this video is because I feel like not everybody can go out and buy a $50 eyeshadow palette or a $40 foundation or even like a $30 concealer, because makeup can be so expensive these days, and I feel like it can be really hard to get our hands on those particular things. So I just went to Walmart and bought some drugstore makeup there and put together this look. I feel like it's a really cute like sunset look. I feel like I'm really digging it. I know that summer is coming to an end, but I feel like this is a good makeup look to end the summer with. So if you want to see how to get this look, then keep on watching. I wanted to start my makeup tutorial a little bit differently because I normally start by doing my eye makeup first, but today I'm going to be doing the face makeup first. So the first step is priming the face, and I'm using the e.l.f. Poreless Face Primer. For foundation today, I'm using the Maybelline New York Fit Me Dewy and Smooth Foundation in the color 210 Sandy Beige. Since the foundation bottle didn't have like a pump or anything, I just took the foundation and applied it on my finger and took my finger and just put like dots all over my face, and then taking a foundation brush, I just blended that all out. For concealer, I am using the Maybelline New York Fit Me Concealer in the number 20, and I've actually bought this concealer before in the past and I loved it, and so that's kind of why I got it again. I haven't tried their foundation, but I got the foundation because I really like the concealer, so I decided to try both. I basically apply the concealer everywhere that I want to highlight on my face, and then I take a damp beauty blender and just blend that all out. So I didn't buy a setting powder just because I had a pressed powder, and I have the L'Oreal Paris Infallible Pro Matte Pressed Powder, and I decided to give this one a shot, but the color is a little too dark, so I just use this to set on the outer areas of my face, and then I set my face in the areas that I want to highlight with a different powder. Then for my highlighted areas, I set my face with the e.l.f. contour kit. They have a very light shade in there, and so I just basically set the rest of my face with that light color, and it worked out pretty great. I was pretty impressed. So after setting my whole face, I am ready to go and do my eye makeup. And for my eyeshadows, I use the Milani eyeshadows, and I bought a little cute eyeshadow palette. First step for the eye makeup look was I took the light brown shade and just softly apply that into the crease, and I kind of built it up so it looked nice and smoky. Then I grabbed the nice pretty corally color and I applied that on the lid towards the inner corner of my eye and the outer corner of my eye. Here I am grabbing a Milani single eyeshadow in metallic Bella Gold, and I'm taking my finger and just applying that on the center of my eyelid. Now back to the palette, and I'm taking that same coral color and just slightly dusting that into the crease because I did get a little bit of gold in there, so I'm just slightly dusting that off with the color. And lastly, I'm taking the lightest shade in the palette, and it's more of like a shimmer shade, and I'm just applying that right at my brow bone to give myself a nice highlight.
It's time for some lashes, and yes, I got the Vegas Snake Grand Glamour Lashes in Walmart, but first, I'm gonna go ahead and apply some mascara, and I'm using the e.l.f. Mineral Infused Mascara. To save some time, I popped on my eyelashes off camera, but the next step is contouring. For contouring my face, I'm gonna be using the e.l.f. Contour Palette, and I'm using the darkest shade on the bottom right to contour, and it's a really nice, cool shade, which is typically the color that you want to go for when actually contouring. And for bronzing up the face, I'm going to be using the color on the bottom left, and which is a nice like warm bronzy color, and that's the color you want to go for when warming up the face. For blush, I'm using the Milani Luminiso Baked Powder Blush, and this is one of my favorite blushes by far from Milani. Like, I'm so obsessed with it. For my highlight today, I'm actually going to be using a loose shimmer shadow by Eternal Color. It's an intense silky shadow in the color Pearl, and it's super, super pigmented, so this is kind of why I thought it'd be perfect for my highlight. To finish off my eye look, I'm going to go back to my Milani eyeshadow palette and use those two colors that are in the heart and just apply that on my lower lash line. And once I'm done applying that, I'm going to go ahead and apply some mascara on my bottom lashes. For the very last step, we are focusing on the lips, and for my lips today, I'm using the NYX Soft Matte Lip Cream in Stockholm, and I absolutely love this color. It's one of my top favorites, and I thought it would be perfect for this look.
And that's the end of this makeup tutorial. I hope you guys enjoyed this video. I'm kind of glad I did something a little bit different out of the box. I know some makeup artists already did this kind of video, so I guess I got inspired by other makeup artists to do this video, but I did find that it was a little bit challenging to do this video because some of the eyeshadows might not be as pigmented as the higher end products, or the foundation might not be as great as the higher end products, but sometimes you just gotta make it work and gotta stick through it. But if you guys did enjoy this video, please give it a thumbs up. Don't forget to comment down below and let me know what you guys think, and let me know what kind of videos you guys wanna see next. And don't forget to subscribe if you aren't already, and I'll see you guys in my next video.